Hello everyone, Duckmaster here, and I'm from Ukraine. I'm working on upgrading sound card and external ducts. So this is my first English review on my channel. So another piece of cool toy came to me for tuning. This will be a short review, and I will talk about the upgrade of the Creative Sound Blaster X5 Titanium HD card. Yes, this time it is a building PC card. So, Titanium HD is a product for advanced sound lovers. It replaced Elite Pro series and has been a modern PCIe 1X interface. The board has a Real Audiofield PCM1794 chip, high-quality LT1965 shunt stabilizers for powering the op-amps. Oh, great, you don't need to change this. And proprietary Panasonic FC capacitors. Also, enthusiast can change the op-amps without soldering. That's great. Well, the task was set to improve the sound quality from the outputs on the RCA, and the card arrived to me. I analyzed the circuit, and it was decided not only to improve the DAC circuit, but also to modify the digital part of the card. This X5 works only at a frequency multiply of 24 and a clock resonator at 24.576 MHz, one found here. But this is bad for jitter, and in order to drastically reduce jitter, I decided to put a high-quality Crystek clock generator here and the same frequency, and provide it with very good power with noise less than 1 microvolt. Perfect solution. The jitter is thus drastically reduced. This proven solution is also called femtoclock. Well, then moves on to the DAC and the analog part. So, what did the Creative do wrong in the DAC? They put a simple AMC 1117 5-volt shunt regulator to power the chip, and this is not the best solution. Most DIRs never change regulators, only capacitors, but this is a very big mistake. You will never get good sound if you don't take care on the power. A high quality voltage source with ultra low noise lower was also installed in this place. So, okay. Near the chip, I put the top capacitor Elna Ceiling 2. Oh, this is really, really cool, and for the impressive sound. It's a digital circuit. I also decided to replace the Panasonic with Elna Carafine. As for other capacitor for 8 forms, say that the Panasonic installed here everywhere work very well, and their replacement does not give a significant increase in sound. Only those that I replaced, because the place near the DAC is critical. Okay, next we move on to the analog part. Yes, there are no op-amps here yet, but don't be afraid, we will definitely choose them again. I really love the sound of Muses 2. The main thing is to put the original here. Elzu is very expensive, but never buy a fake because you lose twice. Well, the red capacitors of Vima FKP2 are visible on the board. I replace this. A very good solution. The cheapest film capacitor used to be here. Oh, Creative, why are you saving $2? Yes, the heatsink on the main chip is the hottest place on the board. Let's help it. But what did the creative do really badly on this product? Look, four electrolytes are missing here. Guessed why? Yes, these are interstage capacitance for the signal. Manufacturers often put such capacitance in amplifier for safety, but why do this a high-level card? If you open the Burr-Brown datasheet for this DAC, you will never not find any capacitors in the signal path. And Elzoo, Elcreative here use the standard circuit from this datasheet. They decided to put these capacitors here on purpose to spoil the sound. Do they really have a more expensive model, which they Zeus want to sell you more expensive? I don't know, but it make little sense and they think. This is a dumb best creative engineering mistakes I ever seen. Well, the card is now ready and my review can be finished. Be sure to write your comment and a little later you can read the customer's review on my work on the sound of the new Titanium below. Don't miss it. Well, subscribe to my channel if you for support my first English report. Also, in the description are my contact for communication. Thanks you for watching. Take care. See you later.